And the clock ticks round. Michael Atherton has now been batting for 10 hours. 454 balls. What an effort by the England captain.
Mike, thinking back to your match-saving 185 20 years ago now, what emotions does it stir in you when you look around this wondrous stadium?
I don't think about it too much, to be honest. It's a long time ago. It's 20 years ago. But, come to some grounds in England, and it's very difficult to imagine having played there because they're so changed. So Old Trafford, my home ground, for example, the square's been turned round, all the stadium's been rebuilt. So it's very difficult to imagine having played there. But this ground is completely the same. It's not changed one bit. The only things different, I think, are the wooden stand over there, which used to be kind of packed, and it's a bit falling down now. And the tunnel where the players walk down used to be open, so you get a bit of abuse from the fans walking down. But other than that, it's exactly the same.
What sort of words were you getting when you walked down there? Well, three or four times?
It was a very hostile ground, actually. Not that many England supporters, lots of locals, obviously, and a very hostile and noisy atmosphere. What I can remember is that everybody on the boundary edge used to lean over and start banging on the tin advertising boards and made a tremendous din. And then there was the band, which is still playing actually in the old wooden stand. It was probably the same lot still playing. I'd put South Africa in, not very successfully, and they'd got a big first innings lead, and then they batted well in the second innings, so they probably declared, I can't remember whether it was before lunch or after lunch, but we basically needed to bat about five sessions to save the game, and did it okay in the end.
Can't begin to speak highly enough of this innings. I think it's one of his very best. It seems the greater the adversity, the greater the performance from the England captain.
What I think most batsmen remember are the moments, like the 50s, the 100s, 150s, because those are the moments that you take to just soak in the applause and have a look around. So I remember the 100 in particular because I've got dropped the ball before at short leg.
And it's gone in and out of short leg's hands. Alan Donald can't believe it.
And then I pulled Donald away for 100, so I remember that.
Here's Donald again. Atherton's got it away this time. He brings up his century in magnificent style. The arms raised aloft.
Does it belong to perhaps a previous era, do you think? Do you think that players like Root and Stokes now would try and win the game instead of perhaps trying to save it?
I think if players of today got in that situation, they would think about winning the game because it's well within their capabilities. Whereas then, we didn't really think about it. You know, just a binary situation. You either draw or lose the game. But these days, players score so quickly, run rates have gone up so far, that I'm sure they think about winning the game. But maybe South Africa wouldn't have declared when they did if that was the case.
It was the first England tour post-apartheid as well. Did it have a special resonance being here in the country at that time as well?
Yeah, it was an interesting tour. We started the game in Soweto. Never had a first-class game before there. And it was a very symbolic game, obviously. And halfway through that game, Nelson Mandela, who was the president of South Africa at the time, just drove up. We weren't expecting him, and he just kind of drove up with a small motorcade, and the game stopped, and we all met him and said hello, and we met him on two or three occasions, actually, in that series. And it was a tightly contested test series. It was a five-match series. It was nil-all going to the last game in Cape Town, and South Africa won that match.
Do people still talk to you about it when you come now? Do people stop you in the street or stop you around the hotel and say, remember that day?
We played South Africa a lot. I think in that decade that I played, we probably had four or five test match series against South Africa. They were all very tight and competitive. And South Africa had a very good bowling attack. So there were lots of, you know, good battles between myself and Pollock and Donald. And so the locals do remember here, or at least the older generation of South African supporters remember it. I'm not so sure about the 20-year-olds.
The clenched fist of satisfaction for Michael Atherton.
So, against all the odds, England achieved what seemed an impossible dream at the outset of day five, batting through and only losing one wicket, and that thanks to the brilliance of one man, the captain Michael Atherton, 185 not out, and the joint men of the match, Atherton and Russell.